I would be talking about zoos. So when I was younger, my favorite thing that I would do with my family was go to the Safari West Zoo back in Santa Rosa, where I'm from. And I love to go there because I had a really big attraction to peacocks and elephants, which were my two favorite animals. And there was both elephants and peacocks. So just as I did, a lot of kids' favorite places to go were the zoo because they could see all the favorite animals they had. Both in television and movies, they see them, and then they can go to the zoo and see them in person. So most of us have been to the zoo at least once in our lives, and it is really enjoyable, but there's also a lot of things that go into that are very bad. So today, I've done extensive research on zoos and how they are banned for this speech. In the speech, I will be persuading you on why zoos are bad for both the community and animals, and how we can end up benefiting these animals in need. First, I will talk about the problems with having zoos, then I will talk about the causes of these problems, and then I will move on to some solutions that we can do to help the animals. So now that I've introduced my speech, I will move on to the first main point, which are some problems. So zoos are typically really expensive to run. According to the Los Angeles Times article, LA Zoo Protect the Animals, last updated June 20th, 2011, the $26 million annual operating cost covers not just the vet bills and monkey chow, but the salaries, pensions, and benefits of more than 200 employees. For decades, the zoo has been run by the city of Los Angeles. The city currently contributes $14.6 million funds, and the cost of operating the zoo is only expected to increase. So zoos are like really, really expensive to run, and they're still being funded by other people just to run them. So then another problem will be the animals in these zoos face animal cruelty, and some of them are brought into these zoos from a very young age, even when they are born. So they face cruelty for the whole life. So according to the website Animals Australia for a Kinder World, an Australian animal protection organization, article, five things we need to stop telling ourselves about animals in zoos, last seen November 2nd, 2017. Animals in captivity across the globe have been documented displaying signs of anxiety and depression. In fact, psychological distress in zoo animals is so common that it has its own name, zoocosis. So zoocosis is common among zoo animals. They face cruelty, so they have their own. So now that I've introduced the problems, I will move on to the causes. So zoos are good for the economy in the cities that they are in because they provide many jobs and wages for those jobs. There's also a local and non-local attraction making more money for the admission. So because of all this, the government and other organizations fund these zoos, and that's why they pay so much money to keep them alive. Also, animals should be treated with respect, just as we should. When we take them out of their natural habitat to nurse them back to health and eventually release them, we forget that these animals have consequences that they must face. So according to the website PETA, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, last seen November 2nd, 2017, article, zoos, pitiful prisons. Animals are often prevented from doing most of the things that are natural and important to them, like running, roaming, flying, climbing. And zoos teach people that it is acceptable to interfere with animals and keep them locked up in captivity, where they are bored, cramped, lonely over their lives, and far from their natural homes. So because we keep these zoos running, a lot of these animals aren't in their natural habitat where they should be. But the excuse for zoos are that we nurse them back to health, we will release them back into the environment, but we don't actually do that. So now that I have talked about the causes, I will move on to the solutions. We can support organizations and groups that actually preserve habitat and help wildlife from extinction. Become informed, donate, volunteer, and join opportunities such as these. So according to PETA 2, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, last updated June 24, 2014, an article, Why You Should Not Support Zoos. Instead of supporting these zoos, we should support groups such as the International Primate Protection League, the Board Free Foundation, and other organizations that work to preserve these habitats and not habits. Warehouse Animals for Life is not the way to save them from extinction. Our salvation lies in protecting their homes, not creating animals in prisons. Instead, visiting zoos, you can help by supporting organizations that help protect them from exploitation and preserve their habitats. So these two websites right here are these two organizations. We can help donate, we can volunteer for them, and they're actual organizations that go out there and help the wildlife and animals instead of putting them behind bars in these zoos. other solution I have is ask the government to stop supporting these zoos. According to the Market Watch article, 10 Things Zoos Won't Tell You, last updated on May 31st, 2011, public ADA-accredited zoos rely on government funding for 40% of the operating budget. So basically, government really funds these zoos just because, like I said before, they're good for the economy and all that. So if we can ask the government to stop funding them, we can reduce the amount of zoos. So now that I have finished my speech, I'll move on to the conclusion. First, I talked about the problems of having zoos, then I talked about the causes, and finally, I discussed the solutions. In this speech, I tried to persuade you on why zoos are bad for the community and animals. And although I loved going to the zoo as a kid, they do come with consequences. And I did love them, but now I know the ways in which I can help support getting rid of these zoos so that we can help